Hello. Good afternoon, good morning, whatever time it is for you. I was working on the script for another video just a little bit ago, and I realized that I wanted to record this video first. And so here we are. I'm going to be walking you through what I do every day with Czech, the tools that I use, the methods that I use to spend my time for an hour a day on average. Today's my 41-day streak. I haven't quite done my whole thing today, and this is actually 40 hours, but barely. So I'm almost at an hour a day, and I'm gonna be getting it up this weekend, but that was from back when, at the very beginning, I was only doing like 30 minutes a day, and so I have to play some catch up. But I wanna walk you through everything that I do, the tools that I use, so that if anything looks interesting, you can use that. The first activity I start with every day is sentence mining. I was unhappy with the Anki decks that were available for free in Czech, so I decided to make my own. And so I use a bunch of different tools to do that. Obviously, I use Anki to save the cards. Since I'm not very good at Czech, I actually have a 1K or a list of just frequent words that I use to then go find. I have this whole list of a ton of words that I just grabbed from Wiktionary. I just Googled Czech 1K or Czech frequency list, and it came up. And I copied a whole bunch of stuff, I think about 1,200 words or so, 1,300 words. And then did some querying in Google Sheets so that I can actually input the script of a video. It will then break out all the text and then turn it into individual words. And then it will find the most common words in the video, and it will compare it to the common words here. And then each of these is just doing a quick test to see, have I found the word yet? And is it in the current video that I'm watching? I click this to true, and it shows only words that I have not found yet and mined, and ones that are in the current video that I'm watching. So when I'm doing this, I have this right over here on the side so that I can see my list and what I'm working off of. And then in my files, I actually download YouTube videos because I find it easier to work with. That's actually going to the programs. That is what I use YTDLP for, YouTube Downloader. Fantastic, simple little tool. I'm on Linux, and so it's a command line tool, and it's actually just a simple command like this, and I just grab the YouTube link, and then it downloads it right away, and then I can put it wherever I want. Then I open up the video that I'm working on. So this is the current one that I've been mining, and I use MPV Media Player to watch it. I also have MPVacious installed, which allows me to take images and sound from a video and put it directly into an Anki card. So actually, let me just show you my Anki cards really quick. There's audio in them. I have my audio muted for this because it's just easier on the tech side. There's the sentence from the subtitle line. There's the definition that I pulled from VocabSib, which is another thing that I use. The target word, and it pulls everything. And I make this in 5 seconds, less than that. So it's super duper easy, and it makes good cards that are easy and fun for me to study. Oh, and one more thing is when I'm actually studying the cards, I also like to fix them a little bit. So for example, you see this is the card we just made, and there's a bit too much information in the definition. So I just go in there and I delete everything that's not useful. So that changed that there. I also like to copy the sentence and paste it into DeepL and then grab the definition, put it into definition 2, and there it is, right? Now I have this full card that took me a total of, I don't know, 10 seconds to make. It's great. When you're actually studying, this is the preview mode of Anki, when you're actually studying, all you need to do is press the E button and it will open up the editor and you can change things. And so for me, it's very, very easy to do. VocabSib is a very simple program that I've actually made a video about that you can watch up in this corner or this corner, because I don't know how directions work. And it basically just looks at the text that is on your clipboard, so like what you've copied, and then you can interact with it. So for example, if I open up this video, it's going to copy the subtitle line. So, and we see the sentence is now in here. And I can just double click on something and it looks it up right away. And so I love this because it also has what's called lemmatization, where you see this word is dravim. I don't speak Czech yet, I'm still learning. But it knows, oh, the actual like root word is this one down here, zdravi. And so then it looks that up instead, because this one, if I direct define it, it doesn't really find that as a word, but it does find this lemmatized version. And so when I'm watching a video and I find one of the words from my list, what I would do is I would hit add note, and then I come back here and I could do control M, which takes a picture, grabs the audio and puts it all in here. So if we preview, it pulled it all right away. So it's a perfect little setup. It takes a few seconds to mine. And what I love is that it actually has this little number down here in the corner, the N16, that's the number of notes made. And so I can just track how many I've made. My target is 10 per day so that I have enough to study in my 1K deck. So that's my sentence mining. I use vocab sieve, MPV player plus MPVacious, and Anki, and then YouTube DLP to download the YouTube video. This channel does have subtitles, I will note, which is how I'm able to get these so easily. So if you can find a channel in your target language with subtitles, that's optimal and super easy to work with. I also use, so Anki obviously to just study, and that's another big part of my routine. That's the other 15 minutes or so, the second 15 minutes. And I have this deck that I'm studying and working through. I've made 380 cards, and I have about 30 in the bank. I like having a buffer so that if I want to delete some or whatever, then I'm not going to run out of cards. My goal is to get to around 1400 or so, and then trim it down to a 1K deck that I can then share with other people interested in learning Czech. But for myself, I'm probably just going to keep going and going and going until I know about 5,000 words, which is part of my master plan for being fluent in 2 years, so as I call it. I'll probably make a video about that at some point, but for now, it is just on a sticky note on my desk. Very modern here at Refold. Anyways, Anki is pretty straightforward, and I also have my Spanish learning deck in the same place, and you can see kind of when this bluer areas when I started my Czech cards. If you're interested in getting the add-ons that I have to see these extra numbers, there is an Anki video, again, in one of the corners, about how you can make Anki work for you to look a little better, but feel a little bit more like a game. The other thing that I do is I listen to an audiobook and read along. I'm very much a beginner, but I grew up listening to and reading Harry Potter many times. And so I know the story very well, and I can actually follow along even though I'm just like a month into the process. And so on my phone, I found the audiobook, and I use an app called Book Player. It's not very original, but it functions great. And all I needed to do was get the file on my phone, and then it's all in this app, and I can listen along. I turned down the speed as well, so it's at 90% speed. And then I got the book in Czech, and then I just brought it in. So this is actually the web reader from Vocab Sieve. If you go to Reader, it'll just open this page, as long as Vocab Sieve is open. And the really cool thing is I can just click on a single word, one click, and it will look up that word. It'll pull the sentence and look up the word. Right, and so I just clicked on this word here and it pulled it, it lemmatized it and it looked it up. I don't currently mine from Harry Potter, but I am looking up words frequently as I notice them, or I'm like, oh, I think I know what that means, or oh, I studied that earlier in my Anki deck. I didn't quite remember the meaning, so I should look it up and things like that. Like I know this one is a word. This one looks like it'd be something like small trouble. Okay, so not even close there. So stuff like that where it's really easy to look things up while I'm listening and following along and verify that I am learning these things. Oh, look, this is the word outside or outside of. Yes, let's go. So that's a big part of my daily process that I really look forward to because I'm like able to understand a story and I haven't even been studying for 50 hours yet. Like that's just so cool to me. I really enjoy that. And now I want to talk about how I immerse incomprehensible input. So I mentioned this channel a little bit, but there is the YouTube channel called Slow Czech. They have lots of videos about various things from various teachers, and everything has subtitles, which is great. And so that's where I get almost all of my videos currently. And what I use when I'm watching a video, I use what's called ASB player, and I can do Control Shift F, and it will open up the subtitles that are automatically there. If you have to make your own subtitles, you can actually use something called freesubtitles.ai, which will automatically transcribe videos in tons of different languages. The Czech one is pretty good from what I've seen, but I think the creator is getting better and better all the time since AI is rapidly advancing. But these, I found them to be at least significantly better than the auto YouTube subs. And so ASB Player allows you to essentially keep using Vocab Sieve just in the browser. So if I hit confirm here, it's gonna load up the subtitles. It actually will also record the audio so you can, again, sentence mine from YouTube videos just like that. It's super cool. So actually I need to turn these off. But if I go later on, you can also see that it popped up here because there's also a setting in ASB Player to automatically copy the subtitles. And so if I want to look up this word, I just click on it twice and it's right there, right? It's super duper easy for me to immerse on YouTube, which is one of the main websites that I use. If I don't want to download the videos that I'm going to mine. Freesubtitles.ai I use for, there's a channel that I enjoy. In English, it's called Honest Guides, but I think it's Guides of Prague or something like that. I don't actually know these Glutzi yet. But I will often download the videos and put them into the free subtitles.ai so that I can get text for them because he talks pretty fast, but they're great videos. The last thing to then talk about that I do every day is record things in Polylogger, because Polylogger is a time tracking tool that you can use. It's pretty good. There's definitely some stuff that is left to be desired about it. But all I do is I just use my phone's built-in stopwatch and I just hit start when I start something and stop when I stop something. And then I put it in to Polylogger as my different activities. So I've tracked every single minute that I've been immersing in Czech in my Polylogger, and it's very fun to see my numbers, my hours. I'm the person who really likes to follow along with those things. I'm very motivated by reaching a certain number of hours. And so you can see your cumulative hours, your hours per day, not like the most useful thing, but I can also look at my hours, average hours per day, which is really useful, or my start date, or the ratios that I use to study, right? I'm doing a lot of vocabulary since I'm counting my sentence mining and my Anki time as vocab and mixed because I'm reading and listening a lot at the same time. So that's what I use for my Czech learning. I hope that this video helps you in some way to maybe give you an inspiration of what you can do in your first month of learning, or some nice tools that are out there that you can immerse with. Let me know what you use. Do you think there's a tool that I should be using for sure? Let me know down in the comments. But that's it for me today. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more videos. And as always, happy immersing.